Alright, fine. So students, in the previous lecture, we have seen this topic, block-wise characteristics of elements. Okay. So what are the characteristics for specific blocks? S block, C block, D block, F block. Okay. By now, you all are familiar with the configuration part. Okay. You all very well know the configuration part. But then, like for example, group 1 elements are called alkali metals, group 2 elements are called alkaline earth metals, okay? Students, if at any point my voice is lagging or some sort of problem you all are facing, then please let me know, okay? Fine? Alright? So these were the things, and then what are metals, which size there are metals, and your S and P block, they are known as representative elements. Your D block are called transition, F block inner transition. So a lot of things we discussed last time. Okay. Moving ahead to the next topic that we'll be seeing today is effective nuclear charge and screening effect. Okay. So students, it is on page number 100 of your textbook. Say to it that you all are on page number 100. Okay, fine. Effective nuclear charge and screening effect. So what we'll do is, like I always explain, we'll read little parts and then I'll explain you all what it is. Now, students, before this, okay, before I start with this, there is a little bit introduction over here. Last time we have finished till here, okay, if you all remember. Alright, after uranium onwards, all the elements are called transuranium elements and they are man-made and radioactive. So, till here we have finished. Okay, fine. So, moving ahead, periodic trends in elemental properties. Okay, students, what are periodic trends? Now, we'll be seeing a lot of trends in the upcoming part of this chapter. So basically, when I say trend, it is like a certain kind of repetition. Or one trend that we have already come across is that elements in the same group have same kind of properties. Okay, fine. So there are certain trends. Now, I can give you one simple example. That is your atomic radius. Okay, fine. So, across the period, what happens? Atomic radius mostly remains same or it decreases. And down the group, what happens? Atomic radius increases. I think so you all are familiar with this point. Okay, fine. Because down the group, what happens to it? New shells are added. Yes or no? And across the period, what is happening? Electrons are added to the same shell. So, this is one kind of trend. Okay, fine. So there are many properties that we'll be discussing which have certain trends across the period and down the group. Okay, fine. As we move ahead, we will understand what this is exactly. Okay, fine. So if I have to begin, students, please see to it that you all have the pencils and everything near you all. I'll ask you all to mark certain important points. Okay. So periodic trends in elemental properties. Now, properties of the elements. Okay, fine. Which property that we are going to discuss? The property that in discussion right now is nuclear charge and screening effect. Okay, effective nuclear charge and screening effect. So I'll explain what effective nuclear charge is, what screening effect is. Don't worry about it. First, let us look at what the introduction they have written over here. Just a minute. Okay, fine. So you can see the original structure of the periodic table was based on empirically observed periodicity in the elemental properties. Okay, students, periodicity means you all can say repetition after a certain interval or a similarity after certain intervals. Okay, like a group of this thing will show something similar nature, and you know, after, I hope you are understanding the term periodicity. Okay, periodicity is like something that is observed. Now, like something that is observed in the first period will also be observed in the second period. Okay, fine. Like atomic radius increases down the group. So that is applicable for first group as well as the last group as well. Okay, fine. I hope you are understanding. What I want you all to do is mark this point. Okay, this point over here. Thus, elemental properties show similarity in a group and gradual variation across a period. So what we are trying to say is elemental properties means your physical, chemical properties, all these stuff. Alright. So elements which are present in the same group, they show same kind of properties. Okay. But when you move across the period. Now students, it is very obvious. Why? Because in your periodic table, on the left hand side, what is present? Metals are present. Yes or no? On the extreme right, we have noble gas and non-metals. So when you move across the period, the properties tend to change, okay? But for the elements in the same group, the properties are a little bit similar. Okay, fine. So just mark this point. Let us move ahead. Yes, Manas, you have any doubt? Okay. let us see what is written. The quantum mechanical model of atom explains the observed periodic trends of elemental properties. We will now discuss in this section the periodic trends in some physical and chemical properties of elements, correlating them with electronic configuration and nuclear charge. So students, just mark this point from here. Okay, that is the new topic that we'll be starting today. We will be discussing periodic trends in some physical and chemical properties, correlating them with electronic configuration and nuclear charge. Students, why electronic configuration? Okay, first you all tell me, what do you all understand by the term nuclear charge? When you all read the term nuclear charge, what is the first thing that comes to your mind? Yes, anyone? Nuclear charge? Anything that comes to your mind, please unmute and speak, it would be good.
Positive charge.
Charge between nucleus and electron.
Okay, one person said positive charge, another person said charge between. I couldn't hear the entire statement.
Nucleus and electrons.
Okay, see, the charges between nucleus and electrons, we don't have charges over there, we have forces of attraction, known as electrostatic force of attraction, which is between positive nucleus and negative electrons. Okay. In simple words, as one student said, nuclear charge is positive charge. See students, nuclear charge is the charge that is present on the nucleus. As simple as that. Okay, fine. Alright. Now we all know, right? I hope you all know the basic structure of atom. There is nucleus and there are electrons around it. Electrons are negatively charged. Yes or no? And inside the nucleus, we have protons and then we have neutrons. Neutrons are neutral in charge, protons are positive in charge. Okay, fine. Now see students, if the atomic number is more, okay, for elements with higher atomic number, it is obvious that there are more number of protons present in the nucleus. Yes or no? Which means that the nuclear charge is more. Okay, as compared to, for example, if I'm comparing it with hydrogen. Now with hydrogen, there is only one proton present. Okay, fine. So if I compare it to some higher element, obviously that higher element has more number of protons, more nuclear charge. Okay, fine. It's okay if you all are not understanding this as if for now, because that is what we are going to study. Just mark this and keep. Okay, fine. So let us read what is written ahead. These trends are explained in terms of two fundamental factors, namely attraction of extra nuclear electron towards the nucleus and repulsion between the electrons belonging to the same atom. Okay, what you all can do is, you all can just mark this also and keep from here till here. Okay, right? So basically students, your effective nuclear charge and screening effect, in order to understand these topics, you all should keep two points in mind. What is the first point? Concentrate on the part that I've marked. Attraction of extra nuclear electrons towards the nucleus and repulsion between the electrons belonging to the same atom. Okay, students, I hope you all know that electrons are surrounding the nucleus. Yes or no? So electron, negative, negative charge, there is a possibility that they will have repulsion amongst themselves. Yes or no? This is one point. Secondly, what is the first one? Attraction of extra nuclear electrons towards the nucleus. Now, what is this extra nuclear electrons? See students, electrons that are present in the very outermost shell, they are far away from the nucleus, right? Agreed, yes or no? The initial nucleus, for example, your 1s2 electrons. Your 1s2 electrons are more close to the nucleus. Your 2s2 are more close to the nucleus. But if I talk about 4s2 or something like that, they are far away from the nucleus. I hope you all are understanding this. So basically, under the topics of effective nuclear charge, we will be seeing that how much a nucleus can hold the extra nuclear electrons, in the sense the electrons that are present far away. Okay, fine, alright. We'll see what that topic is. Just mark whatever I'm asking you all to mark. Let us read what is written. These attractive and repulsive forces operate simultaneously in the atom. This results into interrelated phenomena called effective nuclear charge and screening effect. So both of them, both these topics, effective nuclear charge and screening effect, are correlated with each other. How we'll see that, okay? So in a multi-electron atom, the positively charged nucleus attracts the negatively charged electrons around it, okay? Let me just zoom it in. Just a minute. Okay, fine. See what is written? In a multi-electron atom, the positively charged nucleus attracts the negatively charged electrons around it, and there is a mutual repulsion among the negatively charged extra nuclear electrons. Okay, this is a very basic concept of atom that you all know. The nucleus which has positive charge will attract the electron towards itself, but there are many electrons present, right? So electrons will repel amongst themselves. All right, fine. So these are the two things that are happening inside an atom. The repulsion by the inner shell electrons is particularly important. Now students, what is this inner shell electrons? This is what we have been studying till now, that there is a shell which has a subshell inside it. So your first shell has S subshell, your second has SMP, third one has SPD, yes or no? So all these are inner shells or inner orbitals. Even in that, further it is divided. Your p orbital is divided to three more. Yes or no? Okay. So the repulsion by inner shell electron is particularly important. This results in pushing the outer shell electrons further away from the nucleus. So see students, there is nucleus in center. There are electrons surrounding the nucleus. Okay. Then there are more electrons which are part of the outer shells. Outer shells meaning valence shells. Okay. Shells are which are at the end. So those electrons are already far away from the nucleus. On top of it, what is happening? The center electrons are trying to push them away because of repulsion. I hope you all are getting the idea. See, here there is nucleus. Okay, fine. So here there are starting shells and starting electrons and everything. Okay, fine. Try to assume that it is a circle. All right. And then there are outer shells. Just a minute. Okay. For example, okay. All right. So what we do is what we can consider this as a nucleus, and the first and the second shell, which is close to the nucleus, electrons are strongly attracted by the positive charge. Okay, fine. And then there are electrons in this last shell as well. But students, the problem that is happening is that the last shell is already far away from the nucleus, meaning the impact of the positive charge is more near to the nucleus as compared to far away from the nucleus. Isn't it very obvious? The electrons which are near to the nucleus, they will be more strongly attracted as compared to the electrons which are far away from the nucleus, because the power of nucleus, the positive charge, is not reaching till the end as strongly as how it is reaching at the beginning. Okay, I hope you all are getting the idea. This is one factor. Second factor is that the electrons that are present in this inner shell, okay, the electrons in the inner shell, what they are doing, they are trying to repel these outer shells electrons. Okay, fine, they are trying to repel. So they will go more far away from the nucleus. So it means that the impact of positive charge of the nucleus is even more less. Okay, students, please, everyone, let me know if you all are understanding what is happening till now.
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay, fine. Very simple concept this is. Okay, there is no need to complicate and understand. Okay, right now what you will do is just mark this point. Okay, the repulsion by inner shell electrons is particularly important. This results in pushing the outer shell electrons further away from the nucleus. So the electrons, okay, inner shell electrons meaning the electrons which are more near to the nucleus, okay, they tend to push the electrons which are in outward, like in the last shells, more away. Okay, so it means the nucleus, the hold on that last electrons is becoming more and more weak. Okay, fine. Let's read ahead what is written. The outer shell electrons are thus held less tightly by the nucleus. Okay, it is very obvious because they are going more and more far away. And obviously, the positive charge of the nucleus is effective only till a certain area. Okay, fine. In other words, the attraction of nucleus for an outer electron is particularly cancelled. We can think of it like this. See, ekdam bahar wale electron pe bilkul bhi nucleus ka pakad hai hi nahi. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Theek hai? It means that an outer shell electron does not experience the actual positive charge present on the nucleus. The net nuclear charge. So basically, in simple terms, what one student said, nuclear charge means positive charge. It is what it is. See, nuclear charge means the impact of positive charge, how well the nucleus is holding an electron. So the electrons which are near to the nucleus, they have higher nuclear charge. And the electrons which are far away from the nucleus, the nuclear charge obviously weakens as we move far away from the nucleus. Okay, fine. Now students, here there's one term that you all should all be familiar with. That is the net nuclear charge. Okay, fine. So what you all can do is, before that, just mark this statement at me. Okay, till here, from here till here. It means that the outer shell electron does not experience the actual positive charge of the nucleus. Okay, so the net nuclear charge. Now students, what is, when does the term net come into picture? Net meaning, in simple words, I have to tell you all, net means total. Okay, so now here we are going to kind of study one formula. All right, that formula is used to determine the net nuclear charge. That is, how much nuclear charge is exactly actually acting on any electron. Okay, fine. So the net nuclear charge actually experienced by an electron is called the effective nuclear charge. It has one term, okay, the total nuclear charge. Like randomly in my atom, randomly I'll take any electron and I can find out the total nuclear charge or effective nuclear charge on that particular electron. Okay, fine. This is its symbol, okay, students. Z effective, this is the symbol for it. Okay, fine. Let us read ahead. The effective nuclear charge is lower than the actual nuclear charge Z. Okay, one thing, you all can just mark this, the symbol part. Okay, fine. Further, what is written? The effective nuclear charge is lower than the actual nuclear charge. Students, see, actual nuclear charge is what is